Hi guys, it's Toddy here with Rokombu, and this is the newly announced BlackBerry DTEC 50. So this is going to be the retail packaging. This is actually one of the first samples around, so we were told. We just picked it up, and we want to unbox this thing and take a look at what's inside. So as you can even see on the front here, it says secure smartphone powered by Android touchscreen. So that kind of highlights a few things that BlackBerry kind of announced with this phone. This is the company's first phone of 2016. It's an Android powered BlackBerry device. It's the second of those following the Priv, which arrived at the end of 2015. And BlackBerry calls it the most secure Android smartphone ever. And that's kind of because security is their kind of bag. You can see all over the box, as well as the DTEC 50 name, we've got these kind of like reflective embossed BlackBerry pips here. And on the back, we just have just some disclaimer information. Not really a lot else on the outside of the box. So let's lift the lid off, and the first thing we have is the phone itself, which if I tip over, so this is, as the kind of box highlighted and as they said when they announced the phone the other day, this is the first all touchscreen Android phone from BlackBerry. So we've seen all touchscreen devices in the likes of the Z30 and the Z10, but they were running BBOS 10. This is an Android smartphone. It's running Android 6.0 Marshmallow, but BlackBerry has tweaked and improved upon Android. So it's full Android. You get access to all of the apps from the Google Play Store, but there's some extra layers of security right down to the chip level. So they've worked with Qualcomm to make sure that it's a more secure take on Android. And that's actually true of their previous smartphones too. They've worked with the manufacturers and they've put their own encryption in as well at various levels from hardware to software. So first of all, I'll take off the screen protector so you can see the shield with the BlackBerry pips on front, which is kind of just, I guess, highlighting, reinforcing the security aspect of the phone. Weird noise there, excuse me. That was the screen, nothing to do with me. And then on the back, if I can prise it off, it's actually an interesting texture on the back. And also before I put it to one side, you'll see as well, it shows you the pin entry point and the diagram for the SIM tray there. So presumably on, where is it? Oh, here. So here we actually have the SIM tray pin will pull out, and inside you'll get the nano SIM, and a micro SD card slot. So this phone, it packs 16 gigabytes of internal memory, but also accommodates micro SD cards up to 2 terabytes. So it's got plenty of room for expansion, which is really, really good. The build is nice. It's got this, you know, this polished diamond cut chamfer around the edge here. There's a metallic power key on the right-hand side, which feels, you know, looks and feels very much like a Sony Xperia handset. And the back is this very coarse textured rubberized plastic, which feels like it offers loads of grip in the hand. So it's a really good phone if you're worried about dropping a device. And interestingly, the speaker holes for the earpiece and the microphone might also double as loudspeaker holes on both ends. And they're perforated with these micro drilled holes on both sides of the phone, on the front and the back. I don't know if you can see that. So that might allude to some really good sound if we're lucky. This is actually a reference device modified for BlackBerry's purposes with the DTEC 50 from TCL, who they also make pretty much every Alcatel phone that's out right now. So this is a lot of the Idol 4. And also they're the company behind the likes of the Vodafone Smart Platinum 7, which we reviewed recently. The fit and finish is actually really nice. It's also one of BlackBerry's thinnest phones. I think it's 7.1 millimeters thick and 135 grams. There's no removable battery. It's just built in there. I believe it's a... I'll need to check my cheat sheet for the battery capacity, but I think it's 2610. It's quite a strange capacity. Yeah, 2610 milliamp hours. And then you have a 13 megapixel camera on the back with a dual tone LED flash, it looks like, which is nice. And then there's an 8 megapixel front facer up here. And that is pretty much all of the hardware. No mention of fast charging despite the Qualcomm chipset. That might mean it supports quick charge 2.0. I'd need to check the supported standards by the 617 processor. It's octa-core chipset, I don't know if I mentioned that already, with 3 gigabytes of RAM in there. And I'll just power this on. Hopefully it's got some juice. Maybe not. Maybe not, okay. Well, in that case, I'll come back to the handle with the phone itself once it's got some power. But when you buy it at retail, it should already have charge. So lift up the flap in the box, and we actually have the SIM tray removal tool. It's a very shiny polished one there, looks very nice. And then we have the instruction booklet. So this is the start here guide. And I'm guessing that's warranty and safety information. It's a 5.2 inch full HD screen. There's a single color LED notification light, front facing camera, volume key, convenience key. Oh yeah. So that isn't the power key. That's the convenience key according to this, which is interesting. So the power key is actually over here, which is always good to know. So that's an interesting thing despite looking, there we go. So it does have charge, great. So the power key is actually on the left here, and this is the convenience key, which a lot of BlackBerry phones offer. It means you can program it to give you quick access to certain features. On the BBS10 devices, it also launched the voice command functionality as well. In the box, we also look like we have some in-ear BlackBerry branded headphones. That's quite hard to say, BlackBerry branded headphones. But I'll open these up. Yeah, the phone is turning on now as well, as you can see. It's just like the Priv following the update, so it has the same kind of startup animation. So you have different earbud sizes there for different ears, gold connections, an inline remote, one button remote, and some all right looking in-ears. Quite nice to get some in-ears. As you can see, the standard marshmallow startup screen there. We have the standard USB cable. It's USB, micro USB, not USB type C. That's fine, obviously it won't open that up. And we have a collapsible UK power adapter, so nothing too crazy, and that is the whole box. So now I'll just quickly jump through the setup process and come back once we're actually into the DTEC50's actual operating system. Okay, so I've gone through the standard Android setup process, so we're now into the operating system itself. So this is, as I said, Android 6.0 Marshmallow, but it's running the BlackBerry launcher, which looks for the most part like stock Android. You can see we have the app drawer here, the on-screen Android buttons. It's all pretty familiar. There are some tweaks, most notably with the app drawer here, so you can actually filter by widgets and shortcuts as well, which are actions that BlackBerry has customized itself. And also, interestingly, with widgets, any apps that have widgets, they've actually added in the gesture. So rather than having, say, a widget always set on a home screen, like your calendar, say if you want to just check it without opening the app completely, but you don't want it on screen all the time on one of your home screens, you can actually flick up. So I have nothing in my calendar here, but I've set this to be the view. So if I had agenda points, it would pop up here, and you can do the same. So I can customize, and let's say we have the player recommendations. So now, if I flip up, that's the same as opening a widget. So you don't actually have to have it placed on your home screen at all times. Also, when you first set up the BlackBerry DTEC50, you also have this Getting Started folder, which has everything from transferring content. The BlackBerry preview runs through all of the features of the phone, so you can learn about it, and the help kind of guides you around the interface. Another nice thing is this. I believe they call it the BlackBerry Productivity tab. There we go. And you can swipe out. It looks a little bit like the tab for the Edge screen on the Samsung Galaxy S6 Edge and S7 Edge. Allow. Say yes to all of the things. So here we go. So it's now punching in some of the things from my calendar. So another way to quickly check your calendar or your upcoming events or anything you have in your diary, it can pull into the productivity tab. Now, being a secure phone, one of the things that the reason the phone is called the DTEC50 is because it uses, there's an app called DTEC by BlackBerry, which is actually a really good security app that puts a lot of the kind of underlying Android security features, as well as some of BlackBerry's own, much more kind of in front of the users, things that you might otherwise miss if you're not really into the ins and outs of BlackBerry. So, So what it's showing here is that it'll actually analyze the setup of your phone, and it'll let you know how secure different aspects of it are, with everything from your app permissions to your lock screen. So I'm going to allow it so it can see. So right now, I haven't really done anything to this phone, and by default, it's in excellent condition security-wise, because I did set up a PIN when I first turned the phone on. We've got data encryption by default, so everything is encrypted on the device should it be stolen and someone tried to break into it. Develop options are off, which always means it's less susceptible to attack from third-party apps or anything a bit spurious. You can see kind of everything, how you're using a BlackBerry device, so apparently that's a tick. I don't know what that means. You can get the DTEC app on other devices, but That is a fundamental part of what the DTEC offers. So you have BlackBerry level security built into this phone on the software and the hardware side. There are a few other things as well. So like whilst Google Now on Tap is there just by holding the home button there. What you can do is if I flick up, you actually have three options. So you can go to BlackBerry Search, which is a device-wide search. You can jump to the dialer. And you can also get the BlackBerry Hub, which is, of course, a huge component of BlackBerry smartphones. It arrived on, BlackBerry OS 10. It's one of the greatest features that BlackBerry, I think, has done for user interface and account management. It puts everything you want in one place, all your email accounts, BlackBerry Messenger if you use it, texts and calls, all in one place. So we'll skip all this for now. I'll skip the intro. So right now there's not a lot in here, but you can add email addresses and, as I said, other accounts too, and it all keeps it really quick and really accessible, and it's really, really nice. So that's a look at the software. We've covered some of the hardware, and if you want to know more about this phone, you can drop us a line down below in the comments. You can read the full unboxing and hands-on on Recombo.com, and you can expect a full review really, really soon. Oh, and before I go, I should say the BlackBerry DTEC 50 is going to be available. It's on pre-order now for £275, so it's under that £300 price point, which is what BlackBerry was hoping for, to make it a fleet device, which is basically business speak for more appealing for businesses to buy en masse. And it should be hitting retail and be available from August 8th, 2016. So yeah, like I said, check out all of the content on Recombo.com, and thanks for watching.